The White House escalating warnings about Iran, accusing the country of encouraging its proxies to target U.S. troops, loading missiles onto ships, sabotaging vessels in the Gulf of Oman, forcing some U.S. personnel out of the embassy in Iraq. But whether that intelligence is accurate and what to do about it is in question.
What we've had is this initial intelligence warnings. The U.S., the Trump administration responded to those by deploying additional combat power.
Bradley Bowman, a combat veteran who worked for years on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, says this is not a step towards war.
The deployment of U.S. combat power is not a provocation. This is a common and prudent step that administrations do all the time.
After a congressional briefing last week and ahead of another on Tuesday, Democrats and Republicans seem far apart on what to do next.
There's elements of wisdom on both sides of this debate. To the degree that folks on the left are saying that we should not rush to war with Iran, I agree. To the degree that people on the right are saying that if you respond weakly toward Iran, you're going to get more aggression from Iran, I agree with that as well. I think we can hold these two ideas in our head at the same time and act accordingly.
Senator Lindsey Graham, echoing the president's warnings over the weekend, saying in part, if the Iranian threats against American personnel and interests are activated, we must deliver overwhelming military response.
If we were to get drawn into a war with Iran, the consequences for our global position would be, I think, tragic.
As the president weighs a military response, Bowman says any escalation should be approved by Congress through a new authorized use of military force, or AUMF. The current AUMF is nearly two decades old and was written in the aftermath of the 9/11 attacks.
The 2001 AUMF would not provide authority for a war against Iran. Congress, by and large, has neglected to fulfill that constitutional responsibility, and I don't think that's a good thing.
The president says he hopes this increased pressure on Iran will bring leaders back to the negotiating table.